Mango cultivation is a profitable business, but how much profitable does it is? This question was also come on some researchers' mind of Bangladesh Agriculture University. To determine the profitability of mango farming, some researcher of Bangladesh Agriculture Research Institute and Bangladesh Agriculture University Mamansingh done a complete research study on mango farmers. They select 128 mango farmers on 4 districts of Bangladesh and follow their business from a long time, about 6 years. In this time, they collect all the data of those farmers' business. They also collect the data about farmers' investment, their fixed cost, variable cost, and farm profit and loss on the selected period. After completing the research, on March 2019, they represent some important information about mango cultivation profitability. From this report, you will get a complete and practical idea about mango production, mango cultivation profit, and also the profitability of mango farming in Bangladesh. So let's see the report. Actually, this table represents the age of farms and also the geographical location of those farms. The farms which is up to 1 year, their number was 16, and 1 to 3 years the number of farms was 16, 3 to 5 years this number of farm was also 16, and the farms which is more than 5 years in age, those are number in 80, and in total 128 farms was selected for this research. So let's see the next table. This table represents the average cost of Bariam 3 mango cultivation in taka per hectare. Actually 83 BDT is equal to $1, so you can easily calculate it on your country currency value. So let's see what's on the table. Here is the list of different types of cost which are ongoing on this cultivation period. I want to tell you the total, I mean the sum of the numbers. So up to 2 years, the average cost in farms, this was about 1,04,000 taka, and from 2 to 3 years the cost was about 82,000 taka, and from 3 to 4 years the cost was 81,000, and from 4 to 5 years this was 95%, and in 5 to 6 year and 6 to 8 year this was about 1,10,000 in average. So you can easily understand that the cost in farms was higher in the time where these farms are started to grow. After some years, when the plants are on production, their cost will also be grown. In this time of production, on 4 to 5 years, you will get a good amount of return, and also you have to spend a good amount of money to produce them. There is also a remarkable thing that 42% of the total cost in a year was because of the rental value of land. If you have owned land, that means you are the landlord, then you will get reduce of 42% of costing. So it's a important factor that if you want to make these types of business. So let's see the next table. This table represents the profitability of mango variety Bariam 3 cultivation. So here is the list of different types of cost and the net return. So I want to tell you the final result. Actually, in first 2 year the net return was zero, I mean it was minus 63,000 for first 2 year, and from 2 to 3 year this return will be minus 11,000, and from third year of cultivation you will get start a good return of earning, and in 6 to 7 years old plants you will get a return of 3,63,035 taka per year. And actually these returns will get increase after 6 to 7 year. There is in this research they are not collect those types of data, but it's a common sense that when the mango tree are grow faster and get bigger, they will produce more numbers of food. So more numbers of food is produce more amount of return in this business. So now let's see the next slide. This slide actually represent the per hectare rate of return of investment in Barium 3 mango. This table represent that the average net return on investment in first 5 years was 83% growth. Actually this will be increased after the planter get bigger and get producing more fruit. So you can easily understand that how much profitable that business is. In short, if you want to make question on how much profit in mango farming after 5 to 6 years, on an average the profit on per hectare land, this was about 7 to 10 lakhs in a year, and in US dollar it's about $10,000 to $12,000 per year. So now let's see the next slide. This slide show the distribution of livelihood capital on Barium 3 mango orchard owner. So they increase their living value, I mean the improvement of livelihood. Actually for large farmers this was in human capital this is 60% improvement, in social capital this is 45% improvement, and in natural capital this is 33%, physical capital it's about 50% of improvement in their lifestyle, and in financial capital they got about 44% of improvement in their livelihood. I mean that's a remarkable things to change their lifestyle and livelihood. So this is the last slide, and here is the list of area under mango cultivation in Bangladesh. The blue columns represent the number of area, I mean the number of hectare land is used to produce mango in Bangladesh, and the yellow graph represent the production per hectare. Actually on an average I can say, and you can also see that on an average 1 hectare of mango farm should produce 30 tons in a year. Actually this is the average ratio. It's sometimes it's go up and sometimes it's go down, but this is the average ratio. So I think you can understand the factor of this mango cultivation profitability analysis. So thanks for watching the full video. If you want to get the full research paper, you can download it from my description link. Thanks for watching.